Good morning and good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to NewsOK TV. I'm Dave Morris.
And I'm Angie Bruss. Thanks for joining us. It's Friday, August 24th, 2012. You all right over there?
I am. I'm not sure what I just kicked, but my mic still appears to be on, so that's good. Construction, by the way, continues in the background, so.
Yes, that's right. We've got all kinds of stuff going on at OPUBCO's. Well, taking a look at today's top headlines, New York police say one person was killed and eight others were wounded on Friday morning when a gunman opened fire outside the Empire State Building. Investigators say the shooter had recently been fired from a store inside the landmark building. The suspect shot and killed a former coworker before injuring other bystanders. Federal investigators say the shooting isn't related to terrorism. Stay with NewsOK.com for more information on this developing story. A grand jury reveals optimism in solving the Mitchell homicide. The Oklahoman's Nolan Clay reports the state's 13th multi-county grand jury revealed Thursday that new leads came out of its investigation of the brutal beating of Julie Mitchell, a wealthy gambler's wife, that occurred on November 2, 2010. And grand jurors reported they are optimistic that this case will ultimately be solved. Read the report online at NewsOK.com.
Lance Armstrong, the superstar cyclist whose stirring victories after his comeback from cancer helped him transcend sports, chose not to pursue arbitration in the drug case brought against him by the U.S. Anti-Doping Agency. That was his last option in his bitter fight with USADA. His decision has set the stage for the titles to be stripped and his name to be all but wiped from the record books of the sport he once ruled. Retired Armstrong will be hit with a lifetime ban. He called the investigation, quote, an unconstitutional witch hunt. And the Memorial star Jordan Woodard was in our studio yesterday. There you see it. He made a verbal commitment to attend the University of Oklahoma next fall. Woodard made the announcement during a live stream right here on NewsOK.com. You can watch that announcement and the interview with Scott Wright that followed online at NewsOK.com.
Well, Mitt Romney released his 21-page energy plan Thursday that calls for more state control of federal lands, less restrictive federal regulations, and the completion of the controversial Keystone Pipeline. Boone Pickens initially criticized Romney's plan on national morning shows for not focusing enough on natural gas. Pickens said his comments were based on an early outline of the plan that did not include a discussion of natural gas. After reading the full report, Pickens told the Oklahoman's editorial board he now supports the Romney plan. Watch interviews with Pickens about energy and OSU football from right here in our studios online at NewsOK.com.
The Reverend Jesse Jackson came to Stillwater on Thursday. He spoke at Mount Zion Baptist Church at a rally for convicted Oklahoma State basketball player Darrell Williams. Sentencing for Williams, which will be determined by a judge, is set for today at the Payne County Courthouse. Jackson visited Williams in jail on Thursday. You're looking at video shot by our own Tim Money. Jackson reaffirmed the crowd that Williams has not yet given up hope. He said he took up the case in defense of Williams because he knew his family and the upbringing Williams had in a rough Chicago neighborhood. You can watch that video online at newsok.com of Jackson's visit to Stillwater.
Well, the Department of Public Safety has decided it will move forward with plans to redesign our driver's license. The driver's photograph will be moved from the top right side of the card to the bottom left. And other information on the card will be repositioned slightly under the new system, which will be faster for the operator. That should speed up the line of people waiting at the tag agencies and exam offices.
Isolated to numerous showers and thunderstorms will occur today in Oklahoma. Across the area, with the highest rain chances over the western parts of the state, locally heavy rainfall is possible today, especially after 2 p.m. A few severe storms with damaging winds up to 60 miles per hour possible between 2 and midnight, mainly across western parts of the state. Highs will be in the 85 to 95 degree range. You're looking at your forecast right there. Looks pretty good. Wet weather can be expected through the weekend with high rain totals possible. Drier and hotter weather, as you can see, anticipated next week.
Well, the theme of the Oklahoman's annual football section, which comes out Sunday, is Campaign 2012, and it's filled with fun comparisons between OU, OSU, high school football, and the political world. Pay attention, Sooner fans. The Oklahoman's Jason Kersey reports OU has an overall record of 119-27-7 with two national titles and four undefeated seasons when the Republican nominee is victorious. But oddly, the Sooners are 78-49-10 with no national titles when the Democrats win. That is so interesting.
It's crazy stats. Kind of fun, isn't it?
Wow.
Yeah, what are the odds?
And you know, I'm not a sports person, so I probably read those a little funny.
No, you read them just fine. Yeah. It's just kind of odd.
But yeah. It's so interesting that I guess Sooners are Republicans.
Oh, no. Hey, let's go back to the driver's license thing.
Yeah.
Moving the picture and all that's kind of cool. I have the worst picture on my driver's license. And you,
because this it's okay.
That's what everybody says. You know, my picture looks terrible. It's much better than my passport photo, by the way.
Yeah, so this will be interesting to see it look, you know, a whole different look. I wonder, is it still going to be horizontal or is it going to be vertical? It's going to be horizontal?
It's still horizontal from the sample we had
online. Because
some
people do vertical.
That's right, yeah.
Anyway, interesting.
I think they're rolling it out in the next couple weeks on a trial basis, and then over the next few months, they'll roll it out statewide.
Dun, dun, dun. Mine expires next year, so I guess I'll get one of those.
There you go.
I'm so excited.
See the things you learned today on
NewsOK. All right, you guys, make it a great Friday. See ya.